माननीय सभासदों, माननीय सभापति जी,
फर्दर डिस्कशन ऑन कमिटमेंट टू इंडियाज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एज पार्ट ऑफ द 125th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर raised by Shri Arun Jaitley on 27th of November. When the House adjourned on the 30th of November, Shri P.L. Punia had concluded his speech while participating in the discussion. The House had called Shri Rajiv Chandrasekhar. Please.
Sir, thank you, sir, for letting me speak today to commemorate the 125th birth anniversary of Dr. Ambedkar. So by naming 26 November Constitution Day, the government has rightfully put the spotlight on both the constitution of our country as well as the architect of India as a nation built on a constitution of rights. So I think, sir, many of my colleagues with more knowledge and experience have no doubt enlightened us about the constitution.
Order, please.
And history. But one thing is irrefutable, sir. Our constitution is one of the finest pieces of democratic guarantors that the world has seen. And indeed, sir, unlike the US Constitution, it is one where the entire debate that went into its creation is also documented. So that we not only have a constitution, but we also have the Constituent Assembly debates that capture the rationale and reasoning behind every part of our constitution. So, sir, while we must be proud of our constitution and thankful to our founding fathers for it, it is also important that we cherish its values and principles and live by it. So, sir, the debate on the Constitution should move beyond the preamble. The Constitution envisages a nation that lived by the rule of law, with equal rights and justice for all, with no discrimination, freedom of expression, and property rights. But let us frankly admit that governments and parliaments have let down the Constitution and the country repeatedly. So take the rule of law, for example. It is inconsistently applied and seems to not apply to those who are powerful or rich or politically connected. This repeated violation of the rule of law destroys the core values of our constitutional democracy and often directly threatens the constitutional guarantee to life under Article 21. So take the issue of justice. Justice is often so delayed that justice is denied, threatening the whole idea of citizenship. Freedom of expression under Article 19 has been curtailed repeatedly, starting from the emergency to the recent UPA's IT Act with its draconian Section 66A, which remained on the books despite widespread protests and misuse and was struck down only by the Supreme Court. Other challenges like right to privacy as part of liberty and life in Article 21 continue to be under challenge in the new digital age. Sir, I welcome political parties joining in this debate, even if it is very ironical in some cases. Even those parties that have presided over the chopping and dicing of our constitutional rights through various amendments over the years. Even those political parties that have belatedly woken up to the mistake of banning books and deporting those with politically uncomfortable views. Even those political parties, sir, that have abused constitutional authorities like the CAG when corruption was exposed. Even those parties, sir, that have passed laws like the IT Act and used the power of arrest to attack fundamental rights of expression and privacy. Sir, I also welcome those parties that have used violence repeatedly as a political tool for several decades. It is good that all of them are today engaged in a reaffirmation of our constitutional values and indeed a debate on tolerance and equity. I welcome this, sir. Even after 65 years, sir, Dr. Ambedkar is uniting us around the Constitution today. Sir, I welcome this debate again as an opportunity for the country to start a conversation about how our Constitution and vision of our founding fathers continues to be violated and vitiated in states, institutions, and around the country. I think, sir, it is necessary for us to do that instead of only basking in the great work done in the past and a selective narration of history. There is a lot that is wrong with the institutions of government and laws, and as Dr. Ambedkar himself said when asked about a statement about burning the Constitution, he said, sir, and I quote, "We built a temple for God to come in and reside, and before God to be installed, if the devil had taken possession of it, what else could we do?" We didn't intend that it could be occupied by asuras. We intended to be occupied by devas, end quote. Sir, I end by saying this. The original constitution intended for citizens to have rights and follow a rule of law, and parliament and government to be agents of citizens. But somewhere in the last 70 years, sir, governments all over have become masters and citizens have become slaves and the rule of law ignored. I hope, sir, with the increasing debate and scrutiny, that we transform back to the original vision of Dr. Ambedkar and the founding fathers. As Dr. Ambedkar himself said, sir, and I quote, rights are only real if they're accompanied by remedies, end quote. We are struggling to deal with base issues of poverty and justice even after 70 years of independence. Our constitution and laws must ensure real remedies to ensure development, prosperity, equity, justice for all Indians, which we should introspect if we are really doing this. Our debate must go into why it is so easy for political and government institutions to violate the constitution and law with no consequences. That in itself, sir, is a justification for us to do a review of our constitution and introspect. I hope Parliament and the people they represent can start this dialogue around this today, sir. I hope that we do more than make flowery speeches today and stay engaged on the need to transform our country, polity and economy into one that leaves no one behind. This, sir, is our profound responsibility. Thank you, sir. Jai Hind.
Thank you.